All right. Hello, and welcome to day 7 of Advent of Code. I stream this live over on Twitch, so if you are interested, go over there and follow me. Link is in the description below. It's about a minute and a half out from the start of day 7. And yeah, we'll hopefully not fail too badly, I guess, is the goal. I'm trying to figure out what this map is showing. Not entirely sure. We'll see. All right, minute out. Okay, so let's just make sure I have all my stuff over here. Got my input parsing ready. Input download. Let me CD out and do my watch exec going for day 7. Let's do that. Cool. All right. Have my test file ready up here. Input. All righty. All right, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, what do we have? Oh, okay. So what is the input? Okay, so this is like this is not an easy problem. Okay. Actually, is it just a sum? Let me just read this again. All directories with a total size of at most 10,000 or 100,000. The sum of their total sizes. Okay. This is not the level of difficulty I was expecting for tonight. Ah, shoot. This is going to be annoying to parse. How am I going to do this? Okay, so how am I going to store these? I guess a sort of tree. Alright, so, first challenge. If line 0 equals dollar sign, then is there anything else besides ls? Shouldn't be, right? Are there multiple ever CD? Oh shoot. Let's see. Dot dot. I guess just that. Case dot dot path up to len path minus 2 default is path equals I guess okay. Okay, this isn't working. LS. So this LS, it should print. Shoot. Dang it. Why is it not working? Do I need this? Get rid of this and put it down in here. What? All right, so why is my path not working? Oh, I'm stupid. All right, this is better. I don't think I ever need to handle LS. Like, honestly, I really don't. I don't think I need to deal with it. Okay, so, split on line on the spaces, and then if file info 0 case dir, something. Okay. Okay, so we need like a function that operates on directories that like adds things. Okay, so in this case it's a file, so I want this to be like recursive. So if name contains this, then we need to recurse. Else, don't recurse. View.files subdirs. Yeah, this should just be a tree. So we have our root, and then we have, I guess, each directory will have each one will have a size. I don't know if we need the name there. Okay, let's get rid of all this. Add. So I want to split I want to cut the string name at this. Okay, so if and found, that's pretty handy. I like that utility. Okay, so let's just see if we can do this. Well, that didn't work. Right. Man, reading this in is like really annoying. Okay, so I guess Oh wait, hold on. What's actually null pointer in here? Okay. Well, this is an improvement. Not exactly what I was looking for there. Let's just make it an empty list. Okay. Do we ever need these? Like, do we ever CD into this? I feel like we can just keep track of it using the CDs. Like, we shouldn't need to know about these jurors. Okay, let's just see if this is like at all reasonable to work with. Okay, I need to look up, what am I supposed to use for Q and Golang? I guess I can just use a list, right? Like, that's what I'm supposed to use, probably. Or a linked list. I'll just use a list. Oh, it actually did print it. Okay, cool. No, okay. The way to do this is recursively, I think. Else is unnecessary here. Return. Okay. Size, okay. If s greater than, what is the number? Well, shoot. Oh, shoot. I can't do that. That's fine. This isn't right. So what do I actually want to do here? I want to like look at the top level, look at the I think I want to go back to my queue idea. Oh, well, that's good. Oh, I didn't put it in. Okay, that's definitely not right. This is really annoying. Maybe can I get away with not using pointers? Oh dear. Oh dear. Why am I so bad at this? Oh, okay, hold on. I need to also annotate things as is dir, right? Wait. Shoot. Oh, I'm so stupid. Okay, does this make any sense? How do I JSONify this? I want to JSONify this. Marshall. Yeah, that's what I want. All right, this looks reasonable to look at. All right, let's just see if this is at all correct. So we have A, B, C, and D. Okay. This has the correct size. Okay, A has E, F, G, H. E, F, G, H. These sizes look right. E has I, and then we C, D, C, D, C, D, blah, blah, blah. Okay, LS and D. It's E, J, and K. Okay, so at least that's correct. So, what's going on? Let's just see what directories am I looking at. Oh wait, no, hold on. This has isdir as false. This has to be a pointer. Okay, I have a number now. This is improvement. Oh man. Okay, so do I have isdir being set correctly now? No. That's good. There we go. Oh my gosh. horrible, absolutely horrible. Oh, that was really annoying because you had to like filter out like just directories. At least I got it right first time. This is an improvement, honestly. Total size of the directory that we have to remove. Oh dear, that sounds hard. How are we gonna do that? Okay, I actually have an idea. So we do the same traversal. This will give us the, and we'll make a new map. Sizes. Map. Can we do this? Probably doesn't work. Maybe it'll work. Where are these prints coming from? Whatever. Wait, no. Okay, so what am I supposed to do? The total is this number. Oh shoot, d dot size taken. So this is how much is taken up. If taken minus O, so the new amount of space taken up is less than or equal to total minus that number, turn O. Holy crap, that was bad. Oh, Joshua, what did you do? Oh, BeepBerry. Very cool. Yeah, a couple people have been trying to do various little projects on that. I think Eric likes, you know, from his Pebble days, he really enjoys like hardware stuff. And so he's kind of always trying to figure out ways to do hardware-y stuff. So that's very cool. Oh dear. Eight. Oh wait, no, that was last night. 10. Oh, that was bad. Oh man, Sam did really well tonight. Oh, I don't actually have a BeepBerry. The deal from Eric was like I have to like use it to do something. And I was like, I'm not into that stuff too as much, so. Oh man. Okay, well that didn't go so hot. I like couldn't figure out how to like implement this. There were a lot of like you don't have to handle LS at all. Like this is like it's annoying stuff like this is really just I don't know. Oh well. All right. Let's commit that before I screw it up. What was the damage? Okay, I would. Wow. Okay, this today was. I thought I was gonna be like above 5,000. So like, I don't know. The damage is not too bad. I am willing to accept that. Like this was like I don't know. I don't know. It was kind of an interesting day. Except, yeah, I just couldn't figure out how to like implement anything. Like, oh man. Okay. All right, so I think I need to say that this is an inode. This is where I would like good enums, like variants. Okay, maybe I can afford to do something like this. Okay, so that's on the right track. And then here I'm going to do. Okay. All right, that cleans up things significantly. I agree, Joshua. This was a good problem. I just suck at coding, so yeah, I did enjoy it though. This is actually fun. A nice problem length. Thanks for coming by. Okay, let's make this a lowercase size and then just make this uppercase size. Okay. Oh, perfect. Great. It didn't work. Right, because I did the condition wrong. That's annoying. Okay, is there a way to make these not pointers? Like, it was very, very, very annoying to have to deal with them as pointers. This really isn't a very pointery problem. Ah, that's annoying. There's no reason for that to be anything besides a list event. Let's see. All right, so this works as well. All right, this is much cleaner. Okay, so what's going on here? Basically, I'm reading it into a tree. And you're given like your navigation around the file system is the input. So that, and then you just sort of figure it out from there. Like, the interesting thing about this is you don't ever need these lines. Anything that starts with dir is pointless. Anything that starts with ls is also pointless. So you really just discard those lines, which is really kind of annoying to figure out. Like, I thought I had to deal with them, but you don't. You literally don't do anything with them. You just ignore them. Okay, and then if again, you just continue if it's anything besides the directory. Okay. So then the other thing here was the path. So we start off by like cding to the root, and then if we do dot dot, we just remove from the path. In other words, we add to the path. What if instead of add, this takes in a path, which is a list of the string, and then we get if the path has length 1, path 0, new file size, else this is a directory, in which then we're going to do this stuff. And dir. No. Shoot. So that didn't work? What didn't? Why didn't this work? I do need the else like a moron. So I didn't do an early return. There we go. Okay. So now let's clean this up. This was really ugly. Like, so in the case of dir, we just ignore it. In the other cases, what I'm doing is I'm constructing the path. What a so I wonder if I can just do append path file info one. Okay, that's a lot cleaner. Okay, so then this traversal was really ugly. I think the way to do this is recursively. Like basically I want a recursive function that like returns the size as well as the like sum of the directories under it that have size less than the threshold. I don't know. I think this was fine. So let me move, I guess, so really all that matters in the end is actually sizes. Sizes for each size, if it we also care about just directory sizes. v.fir sizes. There we go. Okay, so this avoids a lot of double computation. It's really funny how, like, yeah, all that matters is the sizes. Okay. Okay, so I don't even need the root size. Yeah, so that does matter. Sorting matters. Okay, that's about as clean as we're gonna get, I think. Okay. Yeah, that's gonna be it. Yeah, this is pretty nice. If only I had, like, you know, actually been able to figure this out while I coded. Yeah, there was just so much stuff here. It was kind of crazy. Okay, so what did we learn from this? I guess, yeah, just the whole tree structure was the way to go. I should have gone with a tree immediately. It was just really kind of annoying because OCaml doesn't, or not OCaml, Go doesn't really have variants, so like it was kind of difficult to figure out a way to represent this as a tree nicely. This is really children. Okay, well, such is life. I think I'm gonna just call it there. Sorry for not having much commentary. I just really didn't know what I was doing for most of this time, so that I can't really say much about it because of that. So let's see who's streaming at this point. See if anybody's still doing Advent of Code. Yeah, it looks like this person is. We'll raid over there. All right. If you're on YouTube, thanks for watching and come over to Twitch. We'll do this tomorrow night at 10.